Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I talk about fragrance. Welcome back. I'm back. Today's video, we're gonna do the ladies version of the top 10 fall fragrance. Sorry for not being here during a week. I wanted to, then there's a lot of signs that told me to not to. Basically, if I'm not feeling well, you will see it straight around the camera. My face is very expressive. If I don't feel good, I cannot pretend that I'm alright. You don't want to hear that, you're not here for that, but let me just explain to you because I like to explain too quickly. My little rabbit Charlie was a bit sick, so I had to take care of him, and I had technical issues with the microphone again, so that's why I was a bit out. I'm ready to start again. So let's directly dive into today's subject. Let's start by the number one, and just before letting you know, I've chose totally different personality fragrance, so then you can choose something that is really, really for you. First one is Chance Eau Tendre Eau de Parfum. I chose this one because the weather is always changing anyway. It's like, oh, it's very sunny and you're like wearing just your little jacket, or like it's very freezing and then you like take your winter coat again. It's very confusing. Why not have like an in-between scent? With this one, you have the freshness of grapefruit and quince notes, which is really nice and very vivid and sparkling. And then the Eau de Parfums got extract of rose compared to the Eau de Toilette, which is nice, I would say, for this fall season because it gives a bit more of femininity and also a bit of coziness. It's a bit more rounder, it's a bit more warmer. I like with this one in particular is the white musk accord that is in the Eau de Toilette as well, but it gives like something very candid, we say in France, you know, like a bit innocent, charming, vivid, youthful. It's quite young scent to me, dreamlike scent. So if you feel like sometimes a bit more girly and you want something like, yeah, you know, charming, like innocent, that could be the one. So dramatic. This is The Revenge of Lady Blanche by Penn Elegance. Look at this packaging. I mean, it's absolutely stunning. It's my fall autumn banger. I always like to wear during fall season because for me, fall is when the leaves are falling, it's a bit more green, earthy tone really, and I want something a bit more green. This is what you have with Lady Blanche. It's a floral green scent, so you've got a lot of iris, a lot of narcissus. Narcissus is my favorite flower ever. Smell nearly poisonous, which is really interesting to say this fragrance smell poisonous, because Lady Blanche, I think, killed her husband by poisoning him to grow in the highest society. What a really nice lady. Charming. Smell very powdery. If you know Chanel number 19, you're gonna enjoy this. It smells slightly more powdery to me. Mysterious vibe. And it's slightly a Arabian vibe to it. Slightly, okay, very slightly. You have to know with this fragrance that it's not your beast mode fragrance. It's a skin scent, very close to the skin, and it's not something that's gonna give you a huge projection. You need to be aware of that before buying that. This one is a male fragrance. Don't leave the video. Don't. I like to recommend to ladies men's fragrance, but you know, I like to open the mind so that it's just ingredients and it's just the branding and marketing. But this one, ladies, you won't be disappointing with it. So it's called Jazz Club from Maison Margiela, the collection of replica fragrance. Stunning on ladies' skins. I remember I was going to work one day and one of my colleagues told me, oh, your fragrance is amazing. And I said, oh, this is this. It's a male fragrance. And she was like, what? Really? Smells much more sweeter on lady skin. So it's mainly like rum, vanilla, vetiver. So it's quite, there's not really earthy tone for me. It's more like a warm, powdery, I would say, scent. You've got really this cocktail-like feeling, slightly smoky, but the smoke is quite round. It's really nice fragrance. It smells very sensual and sexy. You know, sometimes sexy can be a bit invasive. This is like an easy to wear sexy fragrance. That's why I've used so much of it, and I know I will repurchase it because it's so easy. I want to smell sensual, I want to have some character and some cozy comfort. I would wear that and it's just really easy. Oh, by the way, I think, why not today? I'm in the mood of a jazz club. That would be for me like easy to wear during evening because of this booziness that is here, but easy to wear during daytime because it's not too opulent. Next one is one of the scents I discovered recently by the house of Inicio, and it's Atomic Rose. For me to put that in the list is actually something because I'm never used to like a very rose-centric scent. Like when the focus is on the rose, I'm like, not for me. I'm scared by name of fragrance with rose inside. I'm really freaking out when I see that. I know. <well. laughs> but this one, I was really surprised. In the initial vibe, meaning it's Bismuth projection fragrance. Like you smell once or twice and everybody can smell you. That's really initial's vibe. So if you're looking for a good investment with something that gets compliment, like there you go. Projection, but it's a fresh rose. Meaning like, I don't know, it's like toned down with a bit of bergamot citrus, so it's a very fizzy rose. It's effervescent rose, I would say. So it's there, you can smell it, but it's more in a modern way. It's not like the petal of rose, like a bit more vintage. That this is so modern. And how sexy is this fragrance, Samson, ladies? Because of this darkness, this heavy cloud that it's projecting, it gives so much sexiness and femininity. And I remember my friend Rin, like she tried it to before going to a party, and I was just smelling her from fire when I was like, oh my god. It was just giving her another dimension. It was a little invisible accessory, and it gave her like so much like charm and beautiful, beautiful. Oh my god, she's gonna watch this video and be like, oh really? But yeah, you did smell so nice, girl. I feel this is a fragrance that can like attract anyone. This one is an oriental fragrance by Théo Cabanel, so French house that I discovered again recently. So if you want to know more about this house, I'm going to do a video on it. I don't know when, but I'm going to do it. It's called Alain. So what I like with Alain is a powdery oriental scent. So there's a lot of benzoin, so like quite waxy kind of feeling, a bit slightly churchy. Profusion of flower, okay, ylang ylang, rose, jasmine. The ylang ylang is a very solar scent to this scent. What? And there's a lot of Cistus labdanum. Cistus labdanum smell leathery, like a little leather jacket with a bit of flower and that slight oriental, sexy, mysterious vibe. It's not like really too opulent, so I would say for the beginners in oriental scent, that could be really nice. It's a bit more quiet than Atomic Rose, for example, but you will smell a bit more spiciness with this one and something, yeah, slightly leather jacket on, so really like that. We're not completely out of summer, so I wanted to add something quite fresh, and this is my all-time favorite morning scent, I would say. It's called Titonic by Miller Harris. Miller Harris, that is a niche English fragrance brand. I think it's English. It should be English. Anyway, so Titonic is something that really energizes me, especially, you know, in autumn, you really have sometimes this heavy temperature weather. Not even raining, but it's hot outside, but it's heavy and it's gray. Well, this is what we have a lot in here. So usually what I like is like to balance that to get a very energizing and fresh scent. And this is what I find with Titonic. For the lovers of narrowly, slightly smelling like baby powder and love tea fragrances, this is for me one of the best tea fragrances. So invigorating. It's got something very pinchy, like sparkling, vivid, and it's soothing as well. Whenever I drink that, well, I was saying drink that, no? Spray that on myself. I really want to have a little fresh tea, like a jasmine tea or something like that. I really wish to find an orange blossom tea. Does that exist, orange blossom tea? Fragrance that always helps me to relax and to chill when I feel extremely anxious as well. I just wear that and deep breathing and I'm relaxed. This one is for the ladylike, the vintage ladylike that are coming to this channel. I like something a bit more vintage sometimes and I want to feel classy and elegant without giving you too much. This is what I go for. Floris floral set, and my favorite of it is Cypress or Cypress, I don't know. It's a floral scent. What I like with florists is it's traditional perfumery. Really look like a French perfumery, to be honest. It's soft for classy person that doesn't need to show off too much in that scent. So this is really for someone that really enjoy also vintage scent. You've got a lot of flowers, you've got a touch of neroli that gives again a baby powder smell, and you've got vanilla at the end. But don't expect like a very warm, sticky vanilla. No, no. It's very as a backbone, just like to give a bit of goisiness to it. I can smell the touch of orange at the beginning, but really when you smell it, you don't really know what you smell, and that's really typical from earlier scent. Like when you were smelling that, you will not really be able to recognize what you're smelling. It's just a mix of flowers, orange like, and a bit like of warmness behind, but very delicate. This is a royal scent. It smells like something like that Marie Antoinette would wear on daytime. To me, the perfect scent for something like a brunch or something like that, you know, posh brunch maybe not. But yeah, I do really enjoy it. For the lovers of sandalwood, and sandalwood smells creamy, but it also can smell very sharp and dry wood, nearly like a pencil shaving, a bit like cedar, but this one a bit like more creamier. So this is called 301 and Amber, Cardamom and Santal by Bon Parfumeur, French house. So it's nice because it's an ambery scent with sandalwood done in a very Frenchy way, meaning Frenchy is always delicate. It's not going to be like, it's usually not really bismuth. It's going to be treating like the ingredient in a very soft and delicate way, and this is what it does. For daytime, when I want to smell something like quite more woody, it gives something a bit more sensual but also with more character. So you know, with ladies, we are offered in the designer scent a lot of like flower scent. Sometimes I just want to go for something a bit more ambery and a bit more woody, and this is what I go for. It's quite nice because there's a touch of cardamom as well, so it's nearly yummy. It's extremely unisex. A touch of coconut as well at the back, like you can't really smell it, but it's there to give a bit of exoticism to this scent, and it's really really pretty. If you like this sensation of like a burning wood with a bit of like warmness, you're gonna really enjoy that. The amber is quite delicate as well, which I really like. And for daytime, when you want something like quite unique and different, this could be the one. Next one is called Roberto Cavalli EDP Eau de Parfum. Oh, you love it. Oh, you hate it. To be honest, I've got a relation of love and hate with this fragrance, because sometimes I really hate it because the pink pepper is really present. A massive projection is there. You can really smell it. One is to spray and you intoxicate all the place. Yummy side with pink pepper that is here, looks slightly peppery, and sometimes it makes me sneeze. But during autumn, I really like it because it reminds me, it smells a bit monoi-like, you know, like a sunny, a hot temperature fragrance, or nearly like a suntan lotion a little bit. It reminds me of summer, but because of the warm, heavy spiciness, it's really something that you can wear during cold temperature. But yeah, it's very exotic. For me, it's like a bit Latina kind of scent, like a bomba Latina kind of scent. It's so powerful and it gives like a lot of extreme femininity. For me, compared to the other one, this is a bit more bling. So if you like to show off a little bit and you're wearing your favorite golden, I don't know, outfit in jewelry, and you're a bit like more show off, you're gonna go for that. This is ultra sexy, but yeah, bling, trendy kind of vibe. So beware of this, because it's love and hate with this one. But when I wear it, usually I feel really sexy. If you're wearing something like Animal Prints, that will be really nice with that. Anyway, that's what I think. I wanted to give you a little cheapy. Yeah, what would be a top list without our favorite cheapy fragrance? Enough is enough to pay millions for your fragrance. Let's go for something cheap, which is the Zara Collection X Jo Loves, but that's her name anyway. So she created few scents that are, I think, absolutely stunning, especially for the price. 40ml is around like £15 checked, but I think for America, for you, is a bit more complicated. So sorry about that. Ebony Wood, and this one was an award-winning fragrance, as it was one of the best fragrances of, I think, in 2019, and I really enjoy it because it's full of ebony wood. So ebony wood smells like a slightly licorice, I would say, wood. It's very sweet. There's a lot of grapefruit at the beginning, so very fizzy. It's very invasive. It's something that you don't need a lot to spray on your skin to really have an intense sillage. But if you like a woody street fragrance with a very deep undertone, for me, it nearly makes me think of, you know, I need to put a picture of what I'm thinking. The licorice type of bonbon. What is this called? What's this called, this thing? I don't even know how is it called in French. A bit réglisse-like? Réglisse? If you like Angel from Thierry Mugler, okay, it's not the same, but always make me think of this fragrance when I wear this. Very pungy, fizzy, fruity, and intense wood-like, and I really like that. Lots of spices as well. It's not a very complicated scent, but if you're looking for sweet, charming for little price, this one. Playlist is overdone now, so I hope you enjoy, ladies. Please tell me in the comments what is your favorite scent for fall. I think for other people, it's nice to see other people list in the description as well. I know there's lots of people recommending after people list. So please do it in the comment. We all want to know what you're wearing as well. I'll hit the little thumbs up button because it does help the channel and it makes a difference. So thank you if you're doing it. Subscribe to my channel because, because that's it. It's nice. Anyway, thank you so much for being here and I wish you all the best. Also, a little thank you for the people who go to my Utip account in the description box. Thank you so much because it gives me a little contribution, boosts me, boosts the channel. So thank you and I'll see you very soon. Bye now.